An important tangent to the Fibonacci numbers is the golden ratio. In this, we look at the mathematical significance of the golden ratio. If you divide two consecutive Fibonacci numbers and plot the result on a graph, you can see the plotted points cycle above and below 1.6 and are broadly equal to each other as well. This means that if A and B are Fibonacci numbers, B being the larger one, then B by A is approximately equal to the ratio of the next Fibonacci number, which will be A plus B, to B. The larger the A's and B's we choose, the error in our approximation gets reduced, the wiggly lines begin to straighten up till the point where we can see both the ratios as being equal. Doing some minor algebraic manipulations and replacing B by A as L, L because it is a limiting value that the ratios are getting closer and closer to, we get a quadratic equation. Solving this equation using the quadratic formula, you get the value of L as 1 plus square root of 5 by 2. This number, my dear friends, is the highly celebrated golden ratio. And it surely is the number that these dots seem to get closer and closer to. If you reconsider this equation and instead of writing an L here, since L is already this entire block, we could have written L as 1 plus 1 over L. We can terminate this with an L, but L again is just this entire block. And in a similar fashion, we can go on forever. Such a type of a fraction is called as a continued fraction. Representing the golden ratio in the form of a continued fraction is instrumental in understanding two important facts. The golden ratio is 1. An irrational number, 2. The most difficult to approximate by a rational number. Let's tackle one thing at a time. We don't need continued fractions to understand that the golden ratio is irrational. We already know that the golden ratio equals 1 plus square root of 5 over 2, which simply is irrational by sight. But just to give you an intuition, the continued fraction expansion for the golden ratio never ends. If it were to end at any point, we could have worked our way from bottom to top and end up with a rational number. Since there is no bottom at all, the golden ratio can never be written as a rational number. This proves that it is an irrational number. This also tells us a lot about irrational numbers, that all of them can be written as infinite continued fractions. Sure enough, irrational numbers like pi and e have continued fraction expansions that look like these. You may have noticed that the continued fraction expansion for the golden ratio has ones everywhere, while those of other irrational numbers have other numbers as well. This will help us understand point number 2. The golden ratio is an irrational number that is the most difficult to approximate by a rational number. For the sake of simplification, consider two numbers, 3 and 20. Without the slightest of doubts, 20 is greater than 3. But the reciprocal of 3 is greater than the reciprocal of 20. The larger the number in the denominator, the smaller the magnitude of that entire number. Correlating this idea to our continued fraction expansions, you can see that the golden ratio has all ones in the denominators, while other irrational numbers have larger denominators as well. So, truncating at equal intervals, the golden ratio will have a smaller denominator in comparison to other irrational numbers. And then the reciprocal will look like this. As you can see, the golden ratio will be the farthest apart from its rational approximation. This hits a point home, that the golden ratio is the most difficult to approximate by a rational number, because it always lies behind rational approximation to other irrational numbers. Dear viewer, if all of this seems confusing, then trust me, it should. This is number theory that we are talking about. All that you need to know to enjoy the next video is that the golden ratio is in a sort the most irrational number, that is, it is the most difficult to approximate by a rational number. The golden ratio is in the hall of fame of mathematics, not just because mathematicians love it, but nature also seems to have a special affection toward this number. See the next video. Hey guys, I just wanted to point out that the music that you have been listening to all the while in the background has some sort of a mathematical and a Fibonacci significance to it. I strongly encourage you to find the answer out. I'll play the music for you once again. And I'll give you the answer at the end of the next video, in which we see how mathematics and the golden ratio and Fibonacci numbers affect plants, flowers, and nature in general. It's going to be really interesting. I hope you have subscribed to us already, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.